if you are trying to go hard and you're trying to get it done and you're trying to go in deep. The only way to truly do that and to get proper fit is with an adjustable saddle. Because the reality is, Noah back here, who is a Boer cross, and you guys are familiar with Noah, he's like trying to fit a 55-gallon drum in a saddle, and that wooden crossbuck certainly won't sit on him right. Then you got Merciless or Ridge here, that are those A-framey Alpine goats. They're shaped like this. Noah's shaped like this. How do you fit them? The other thing that people don't consider is that a goat very often, especially like Chester, my lead goat, he has a big rumen. So he is actually, he's not only narrow, but he's actually wider in the back than he is in the front. So if you look at Chester's saddle, when I custom fit it to him, it fits like this. So it's different here and it's different here. And this is the only saddle that does that functionally. Now there is one other aluminum adjustable saddle on the market and I've owned it. In fact, if you look at all my early videos, it's what I put on there. It was my last, man, there's gotta be a saddle out there that won't chew up my goats. And it did, it still chewed up my goats. In fact, if you look at several of my goats, you'll see the rubs up front. And the suggestion I got from that manufacturer was to put a pony saddle or a pony blanket underneath the already established pad on that system to offer double layers of padding so it didn't chew holes in the shoulders of my goats. I didn't want to do that. That's a ton of material. It's heat dispersal. It was extra cost. It was all those different things. And then that's what led us down this road. This is the fully adjustable saddle. It has bolts on all four, and this thing is super heavy duty. You can loosen all four of these, or all six of these bolts, and not only does this saddle then flex this way, it flexes this way. And because of that, you can custom fit any goat, and then once you settle it into its position, and I have a video that shows you how to fit this, it's not hard. Once you settle it into position, then you have the capability to set that on that goat and it is custom fit every time. But here's the key, it's rigid. And because it's rigid now and it's custom fit, the double cinch is super nice, but you don't have to have heavy cinch pressure. In fact, you'll be amazed at how light the cinch pressure you need to keep this both in position and from spinning. The other thing that you'll notice is that we have the furthest forward insertion point on the cinch of any saddle that's ever been built. And the reason is, when you put this in here, it ends up catching them too far behind the shoulder, and you end up, instead of being up here on their chest where they have musculature and they have a sternum and they have everything to load that cinch with that pressure and be that stable place to hold that cinch in place, you now have to drop it down here. And if you want to give yourself an example of that, is literally just press hard here and press hard here. Which one are you more vulnerable at? Well, they're the same. So they can take a strap here really nicely, but because the way this cinch is, you have to bounce it back here on all the other saddle designs, even including ours, because there's no room. So when we were able to put it up here, we brought that cinch back and it fits now perfectly right behind the shoulder where you want it. So traditionally on these saddles, come on, Ridgie. So traditionally on these saddles, you end up with a cinch that when it drops straight down, it actually is clear back here. Because remember, when you're putting this, that cinch here, you can see even when the saddle sits perfect, as it is, this is Ridge's saddle, it fits him. If I drop down that cinch right here, it would be too far back. You know, I'm clear back off the shoulder. But because it drops down here, I'm that perfect hands width right behind the shoulder where I wanna be, and it sits naturally. Now the problem is, and you'll see this in single cinch designs, when you have a single cinch design, especially with it positioned forward like ours, once you cinch that front cinch down, this saddle wants to ride a wheelie. And that adjustable aluminum saddle I talked about before, it is a wheelie master. It just stands up like this until you put weight on and then the pannier holds it down, and it's just not a good design. So anyway, the cinch comes down in here, but we have taken the back cinch and brought it clear back far, and at an angle so that we can put that rear cinch and create pressure to have that saddle sit perfectly. So now we have fit. Now what about the other two options? The other two options that are really, really neat on this saddle is that we've gone to the yoke. Now the yoke was something that I was a bit skeptical about. I didn't know how well it would work, and it works so good, it's ridiculous. Its inherent flaw is that it gives a little bit more to hook up on going through the brush. It's not a big deal. It's not like I have it happen often, but it is a deal. The other thing is this, but this yoke design and how it fits allows for pressure and where it ends up exerting pressure because of how it fits. Sorry, Ridge, you're just sick and tired of this, aren't you? So how this fits is it clicks in and then we put it in here. So now when the pressure is exerted, you can see that that pressure is exerted equally over this shoulder space. And number one, you're not gonna get chafing, which all the other breast collars do. They chafe because they slide back and forth as the goat walks. But also you'll notice it's a cough fest. All your goats are coughing. Why? Because that breast collar is pushing against the esophagus right here. They're trying to breathe hard and its major pressure point is right here versus the yoke design, which its pressure point is equally distributed across this whole surface. Because remember, that's what this is all about too, is surface area. We want the most amount of saddle touching the goat as possible to disperse that weight across his where he can carry that. So the better we can fit and the more perfectly we can fit in a larger area keeping contact, the better. The problem with that wooden crossbuck that's set, for those goats that it doesn't fit, you end up sometimes with as little as 10% of that actual crossbuck touching the goat. And any good horseman will tell you that it does not matter how good the pad fits. It's all about the under portion of it. It's called the tree. And the tree is what's important. So if you want to see if yours fits your goat, you put the tree on with no padding and then you see how well it fits. That's where this one comes in. And the other component is you save the money of needing a whole nother pad and dealing with that extra piece of equipment by the fact that the pad comes with this design. The last thing is we do have our adjustable and fit britchen. And you'll notice again, it's the same as I explained to you before. So that is kind of how all the saddles break down, and their positives and their negatives. There's positive and negatives to our saddle. There's positive and negatives to every saddle that's out there, and money doesn't grow on trees. So I thought it was really important to kind of break down the whole portion of the saddle, how to think about it, what works, what doesn't. One last thing I wanted to show you visually before we finish is this is the difference between Noah's saddle and Ridge's saddle. Now if you actually, and the easiest way to tell this is to flop it over. So if you actually look at this angle of that saddle, this is Ridge's. Now Ridge's is more of a narrow goat. You'll actually notice that on this saddle that it's actually tipped in, okay, when I hold it there. Now, the other thing, when you look at Noah's in that same way, his is actually tipped out. So now you have at least this much of a degree difference in the fit between Noah and Ridge. So you can see that those two side by side, and it's so hard to do it, you can see how much wider this one is than this one. The other thing that I want to quickly show you with Ridge, Ridge is a goat that if I asked you, hey, Mark, is Ridge an example of a goat that's wide in the back and narrow in the front? I would have looked at him and said, not really. But when you look at his saddle fit, it definitely is. So you can see the gap here versus the gap here. So he is a goat that is narrower on his front and wider in his back. So not he is an example of a goat that is adjustable in two different ways. So again, I would ask you just to remember that I acknowledge that money doesn't grow on trees, that all of us are gonna use these goats for different reasons, and at the same time, if you're gonna require a lot of work out of your goat and you want them to perform for you, get them a pair of shoes that'll fit them. And if you can't afford a pair of shoes that are gonna fit them, get them a compensating mechanism through additional gear that will help to offset the lack of fit and help to perform your goats well. And if you're just looking to save money and you're not looking to use your goat super hard or load a lot of weight, the new soft saddle is definitely the way to go. So I hope that's helpful for you. And this is Marc Warnke at PackGoats.com.